Good evening, YouTube. This is Killing String coming at you with my contest entry for the Minotaur Trading Company Ration Cooking Contest. I apologize in advance for any extraneous noise. I am outside on my deck, and hopefully I'll be able to make this work. Because I want to try to do the actual cooking out here. First, I'm going to show you what I'm going to be using. Some of the elements from this menu 6 from Minotaur Trading Company chicken curry. I also have the instant white rice. I ordered that as a separate item. And then out of the spice kit, garlic salt, curry, these are out of spice kit 1. Oops, sorry, I don't think that was low enough, sorry. There's the garlic salt. And I got that as a freebie with my last order. Not this order, but as a separate item, I ordered the sesame seed. And out of my own kitchen, I have some cayenne pepper, or no, Spanish paprika. Sorry, I saw the cayenne pepper in one of the spice kits. And then I have some turmeric. And some onion powder. So in here is half a can of drained and rinsed chickpeas. Now I will open up. I'm going to stand up to do this. As you can see, I had not opened this bag previously. So what we have in here is the basic pack. It has crackers, strawberry jam, peanut butter, sweetened condensed milk, cream cheese icing, coffee, sugar, creamer, true lime, true orange, a drink mix, moist towelette, hard candy, and it says a spoon. It's a smaller spoon, and salt and pepper. So here is the chicken curry. The flameless ration heater, which I will not use. Sugar cookies. Chocolate covered sunflower seeds. Oh, another instant rice. So I guess I have an extra instant rice, so I can save one of these. These are both the same, just different label. This is an Emory Nation instant white rice, so I will toss that aside since I have this one. And for the time being, I will put aside the sunflower seeds and the cookies. I will go ahead and open up the basic pack. The drink mix is orange flavor. I'm going through the basic pack because I want to I will not need the salt because I have the garlic salt. The pepper is what I want. So all of the rest of this will go back. In here. I'm using my Emory Nation to hold my smaller spice containers in for now. I also brought out the spork. To pause this while I get set up to do the first thing. Okay, I am going to light my stove on this stool because this Ozark Trail fabric table will not be stable enough, and my deck rails are not wide enough. I'm going to use this. I put enough water in there to do the rice and the coffee. That'll just sit there and work. There is the rice. Even though the pouch has a gusseted bottom, I'm going to use this canteen cup to to hold it in. Cracking open my seasonings, the ones that have not been opened before. And I'm using the blade portion to do that. Some of this I'm doing off camera simply because it's just easier because I'm standing up. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take some of the curry. Put it in the rice. Do the same with the garlic salt. little bit of the turmeric, not too much. Just put in some of the paprika. And the onion powder. And I'll throw the pepper in. Dry mixing. So I'm done with the seasonings. I'll be putting them away. Now I'm going to have myself coffee. And I will be using the sweetened condensed milk. Water is done. pour water in the rice. Coffee is made, my rice is done. Now I'm going to open up the curry chicken. I'm going to put it in this pan. Trying to get all of it out. Because I don't want any of this goodness left behind. The water that's left in the pot. Which there wasn't a whole lot. Swishing it around. I want just a tiny bit of extra liquid. Because I'm going to be adding the chickpeas. I'm going to be tapping in some paprika. add just a tiny bit more water from the bottle. I'm going to flare up the stove again. Let me turn you around so you can see what I'm doing. I will have to hold this because this pan is probably too big for this stove. But I'm going to stir in the chickpeas into the chicken. Turn the flame up just a little bit. I'm going to call that done. I just have that sitting down there because that is a much stabler surface. Oh, what the heck? I'll go ahead and make up the drink mix with the water that's left in my bottle. just gonna shake it in a bottle and then pour it into my canteen cup. This is an insulated bottle. This has a beaner on the cap. This bottle is usually the one that lives in my get-home bag. Now that the drink is done, now it's time to show you what my creation is going to be. I'm just going to go ahead and turn this back this way. This is just a fabric table, so everything is kind of at a... It dips in the middle. To use the spork to get the rice out because the spoon that was in the basic pack would not be long enough. And yes, I am making a mess. See, the turmeric gives the rice a nice yellow color. And the paprika adds a little bit of red to tone down the yellow. This moving my mugs back, and this chicken biryani ration style. Thank you. just bring my stool back so I can sit. Give you a close-up of this. As I do the final step, see the sesame? I dumped the whole thing in. This is delicious. This is a usual, most of the time biryani looks like this color. It may not always have sesame seeds, but I chose to add them. It may not always, it usually does have chickpeas. And it is always involving rice. There is some of the rice by itself. So again, this is the Minotaur Trading Company chicken curry. Sorry, motorcycle. This guy parks his motorcycle on his patio and he rides right down out of the yard. Drink of the coffee. I didn't use a whole lot of water because this coffee, you know, if you want it full strength, you have to use just a little bit of water and you double up on the coffee packets. I'm going to take a taste of the orange drink. It's not too bad for one of these kinds of drinks. There's a bug that wants to freeload. So I hope this counts as my entry for the contest. I don't know if I had to use every single thing from the Ration itself or just the main. But this is what I've chosen to do. And if you get the chicken curry, I hope you try making it into biryani. And if you get the chicken curry ration, it will have the rice in it. So I wasn't sure if it was going to have the rice in it or something else. I mainly bought it because I wanted the chicken curry. And since it already has the rice in it, I will save that rice that I bought separately for another time. So, cheers to Black Dog Bob for coming up with this idea. And he and Dub C gave an example of it when Dub C was camping with Bob for a night, and they took elements from the Poseidon 72-hour box and mixed it up along with spices and some other things. So cheers to those two for giving examples of what you can do. And this is in the same line that Michael Green over in England does, where he has taken elements of a ration, combines it with elements from his own kitchen to create a meal or a dessert, and he serves it to his family. But I'm definitely going to be enjoying this. This is going to be a very filling dinner, so I will not need to eat anything else. The crackers will wait for another day. And the cookies, I think I'll probably just have an apple chaser after this. And I apologize for the motorcycle. So I'll show you the ration bag again. Menu 6, chicken curry from Minotaur Trading Company, turned into chicken biryani. I did not measure what I put in as far as the seasonings. I just felt like what I put in would be the right amount, and it worked. So, thanks for watching, and catch you on the flip side.